What you are looking at is a more than 1,200-foot-high sustained lava fountain generated Wednesday at Hawaii's Kilauea Volcano. This spectacular feature was easily viewable by the surrounding public for a full 8 hours and 11 minutes on June 11th, with the molten rock being propelled upwards by the rapid expansion of gas in the rising magma. These lava fountains mark the 25th such episode Kilauea's summit has produced since December 23rd of last year, and specifically produced the tallest lava fountains in comparison to the other 24 cyclical events. These cycles have occurred in a fairly predictable pattern, which is described here, with each cycle lasting anywhere from 5 to 10 days during the last 4 months. This means that if you happen to be in Hawaii and the volcano's webcam show it beginning to erupt sustained small lava fountains that are increasing in height, you probably want to head over to the designated safe viewing areas within Hawaii Volcanoes National Park to watch the incredible show for yourself. However, get there early to try and beat the crowds, as it should come as no surprise that an unusually large number of tourists are seeking to view this unique activity, which is truly a once-in-a-generation event. Seriously, Kilauea hadn't produced sustained tall lava fountaining episodes for a full 39 years until the very end of 2024, meaning this is truly special activity. While not proven, I suspect that a combination of a near-vertical magma conduit, an above-average magma supply, and a higher-than-normal level of volatiles, mainly carbon dioxide and water, are creating these unusually tall lava fountains. If this is found to be the case by U.S. Geological Survey scientists, I'll be sure to let you know. If you do view these towering lava fountains during the expected episode 26, which is likely to occur sometime between June 16th and June 21st, you might experience a hazard not frequently associated with this shield volcano, ashfall. And some of the falling tephra has a golden color, no really. What I'm referring to is known as Pele's hair, which is a type of volcanic glass associated with certain basaltic eruptions. It forms when a thin film of lava is ejected upwards as a result of a volcanic bubble bursting during lava fountaining. This stretches small amounts of molten rock originating from the edge of the bubble into incredibly thin and elongated strands of material, and since it cools almost instantaneously, it becomes a type of volcanic glass. While these are quite pretty, they shatter incredibly easily and, much like cactus spines, can be an absolute pain to remove from your skin, so it's best not to touch them. This tephra, which is largely emitted as low-density particulates and fragments during tall lava fountaining episodes, has really piled up to a substantial level on a highly localized scale just southwest of the two active vents, in one particular spot reaching a whopping 12.2 meters or 40 feet thick. Thankfully, the angle of the two vents away from the town of Volcano and the vast majority of viewing areas is preventing a problematic level of tephra from accumulating on nearby structures. Now, when looking at the thousands of falling simultaneous lava fragments from Kilauea's latest lava fountains, you might notice something interesting. The darkest rising eruption plume is not rising from the lava fountains itself, but rather from where the material falls. This is because on impact, the now lengthened falling lava fragments reach a high speed and shatter on the ground, and much like throwing a brittle rock onto loose soil, it shatters and releases many fine particulates, including what could be defined as ash. And because of the temperature of the fallen lava, which is around 1200 degrees Celsius or 2192 degrees Fahrenheit, it causes hot air to rise above it, thus pushing up the ash and fine volcanic particles to high altitudes, which in the case of the latest eruption may have, in my opinion, reached around 13,000 to 14,000 feet elevation. So far, since December 23rd of 2024, a total of 112.8 million cubic meters of lava has erupted, equating to an average of about 7.59 cubic meters of molten rock per second. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Andre Gulbis, for supporting my work.